This is Terry, and welcome to my next build video in my Mini Camper Teardrop build series. And in this build video, I will actually be making my support beams that will support the ceiling and also support the roof. And what I've got to do is make these support beams. Now, a lot of people who are building these campers are calling these beams spars. So I'm going to start calling those spars just because everybody else is. But I'll be making spars. And if you recall, when I cut out the half inch, the inside wall half inch, I had this piece here left over. So I'm actually going to butt that up to my outside piece and use these as patterns. And you'll see why I'm going to be doing that later. So what I've got to do next is just go ahead and I'm going to put a spar on the bottom, and then I'm going to go up so much distance and put another spar, and then put another spar and put another one. But I definitely want a spar on every seam that I've cut, because there's actually three on top. So what I'm going to do is kind of measure from those spars this way and the other way. And they may be 12 inches, they may be 16 inches. I'd rather do 16 inches, but I may end up doing 12 inches. So I'm gonna go ahead and measure that out. And when I get that measured out and give an idea of where these spars are gonna be, I'll just come back and show you guys where they are. I've cut my 1x2s in half, and not to length, but just in half, and I've got to put these together. These are gonna be the spars. I looked at it and I measured that I was going to need 10, and I'm going to go ahead and make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and that should be more than adequate just in case I have a problem with one of them or cut one of them short. So that's the plan. So let me go ahead and put these 1x2s together and make them spars. I've got my spars made. They're not cut to length. I'm not going to cut those to length until I actually have the position where they're going to be placed, because I want them to be nice and snug. So that'll happen whenever I put these spars in their permanent place. So let's go ahead and continue with the spacers on the outside. Okay, I've measured where I want my spars at, and I'm gonna have one on the bottom front here. So there's one. Let's see here, two, three. Oh, sorry, I forgot one there. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. I'm gonna have 10 spars. It's gonna be running across here, and the top two spars up there is going to be 14 inches apart to fit my fan, my RV roof fan. So the next thing I've got to do is to take this out and cut out where the spars are going to fit into, and then I'll actually use these as patterns. I've actually got these numbered, so these are going to be patterns on my 1x3 boards that I'm going to use. And I'll put the 1x3s here, put my spars in between them, and you'll see as we go through and start building. So let me go ahead and cut these patterns out for the spacers between the spars. Okay, I got my pattern spacers cut. here. So what I'm going to do now is I've got some 1x4s, I think they are. I was going to get 1x3s, but they were just, you know, total crap at the store. But anyway, I got 1x4s. So I'm going to trace these onto the 1x4s and cut those out. So these will be patterns for both sides, the driver side and the passenger side of the trailer spacers. So let me go ahead and make a couple of those and maybe cut some spars and put them up on top just to show you what I'm doing. Show you what I've got on top. This is my two back spars, and I've got this double because of the hatch. I want to make sure the hatch will lay down and not bow up or anything like that. And I put my spacers in both sides here, and there's a little notch up there, and I get a pin and scribe that and smooth that out. And I've got the other spacer over there, so it's a matter of putting on the spars, the spacer, and the spars, and the spacers, and a spar, and a spacer. And I'll be doing that all the way to the front. So what I'll do, if you can see on the very bottom over there, there's a few little spaces right there, but I'm gonna get a pencil and go that and scribe that and see if I can get that a little bit smoother. And of course, that's a little bit higher on top. And I'll also get a pencil and scribe that and make that even with the top as best I can. So I'll go ahead and do that next. So again, that's a process. Spars, spacers, trim, spars, spacers, trim. And I keep going that way. So let me go ahead and trim these out here and sand this off so I can get a better fit. Okay, I got this piece sanded. Under the bottom, I did a better job than I was gonna do. I had to end up hand sanding some of that. The top is just about perfect on top there. And I'm gonna have some imperfections. You know, you can't get it 100% right. There's gonna be higher and lower spots between the spars and the spacer. So after everything is together, I'm going to sand everything smooth and make sure that everything is nice and level as best I can all over the top. So so when I put my roof on, everything will fit flush on that. So let me go ahead and start making the spacers and the spars and putting them on here. I'm going to dry fit everything, and when I've got that done dry fitted, I'll come back and show you what I've got. I've got my spars in, and I've got my spacers in. They're just all dry fitted right now, and it turned out pretty good. I'll put some dividers in and support in here, and also in the back. And also I got to frame my fan opening up here. Before I put those dividers in, I'm gonna go ahead and permanently mount the spars and spacers that I've got now, and that's just a matter of gluing and screwing those in. And let's go ahead and get started with that, and I'll try to get that finished today. Okay, I've got my first bar in. I've got it glued and screwed, and I got it clamped, and I've got some paper so my glue won't spill off on my shelf here. So I'm going to leave that there while that is curing. I'm going to go ahead and start drilling holes on my next spar and get it ready to put in. Okay, on the very top of the camper, the spars there, the ceiling is so thin that it's kind of, you know, bowing like this a little bit. So I've got some wood bond here. I'll show you weld bond contact cement that I will be using between the spar and the ceiling on that 1/8 inch plywood just to set it up. So that's what I'm going to use instead of the regular tight bond up under the spars on top of the ceiling. So I'll show you how I'll apply that, and I'll go ahead and apply that to one. Well, even though it was a mess, this stuff seems to work really good. I let it dry for 20 minutes and then stuck it together, and it really works good. There's no gaps that I can see between there. You can just see the line marked where I marked where I was going to spread the glue, but it's solid, so that's good. So I'll have to do that to at least this bar here. I'll have to do that. As you can see me do that, when I do it over here, it does not separate. So I'll have to put it on at least this bar, or maybe the couple of front spars, but at least the next one here. So let's continue. Okay, I've finished adding my dividers. I added two dividers in the back to give me some extra strength for my hatch door as it comes up to keep it from bowing and flexing. I also added some dividers here. This is going to be the area where my fan, this exhaust fan, is going to fit right into. And I've actually taken my fan out and made sure it will fit in there. It's 14 inches by 14 inches. And I also added another spar cross beam on front. This one right here. I did not have any, and I wanted a little bit more support on my roof when I put that on there. So that's going to be it for this video. In the next video, I'm going to actually be doing something a little bit different. I'm going to be doing my electrical work. I'm going to be running my wires and mounting some electrical devices, some lights, and probably the fan. So hopefully I'll get started on that tomorrow. So thanks for watching. Please continue watching, like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys on the next video. Thanks.